What's up, everybody? Dave here from the DaveyHT3 with another What's in the Box. Today, as you can see, we got the Gaui NX4 in front of us that we're going to go ahead and unbox. It's designed by Bobby Watts, and it's one of the only 500 size nitros on the market at the moment. I think they tried something with the Align 500, an upgrade kit or something where you could make it nitro, and reviews were mixed. It kind of worked, it kind of didn't. I looked into one, but I never pursued it. But the point is, I always wanted a nitro heli that was fairly affordable, you know, small, easy to clean up the nitro after you get it all dirty, and, you know, affordable, and it's also kind of geared like a electric heli, so, you know, a lot of great benefits here. You're going to get a lot more flight time, it's going to feel like an e-heli that you're used to flying, or at least I am, and, you know, we're going to give her a shot. So first I'll run through the technical specifications, and then we'll go ahead and go through the box. Let's go through some of the technical specifications. It's a 500 size nitro, runs on a 037 engine. Gaui has an OS 037, and OS has its own, obviously, OS 37 motor. This is designed by Bobby Watts. It swings 435 millimeter main blades, 70 to 77 millimeter on the tails, runs mini servos, torque tube tail drive, direct servo linkage, so there's no bell cranks. The servos directly hook up with the swash plate there, so it's pretty simple to set up. This is available in three different flavors. You can get the basic kit like I have here, retails for $449. You get the kit with carbon fiber mains and tail blades, Gaui's blades, for $499, or the super combo that has the Gaui blades, Gaui governor, Gaui V-bar, Gaui OS 37 motor, and the kit, and that retails for $1,250. You're looking at 6.5 to 8 minute flight times, 15 flights per gallon of nitro, which is just outstanding. That's very economical. And like I said, this is geared like an electric heli or an electric feeling heli. The gear ratio is 7.06 to 1 on the 120T main gear and the 17T pinion. So without further ado, let's go ahead and crack this box open. I'm going to go ahead and open the bags and try to get really into the parts so you guys can see what you're dealing with here. I don't have all the parts I need for this heli. I'm not rich. I couldn't afford to just buy it all at once. Pretty much just stagger it over a bunch of paydays. So I'll be billing it and doing updates as I get the parts in to complete the heli. So I hope you guys enjoy. Go ahead. Pull out this box here. Just so you know, I've already been through this, kind of checked the contents, so got your owner's manual right on the top, printed manual. I went through the manual online before I ordered it. Really well written, clear, easy to follow. We got your manual right there on top. I guess we'll start with this box here. In here, and you would find your blades, your torque tube, all that good stuff, tail boom supports. Won't find any blades in this one, unfortunately. I'm thinking I'm gonna run the edge blades, give them a try. So here's our bag with our torque tube in it. Very beefy. It's not a tiny torque tube at all. All right, got that out. Go ahead into this guy here. Now in here we'll find our exhaust shroud and our cooling fan. Like I said, I'll go back through these packages so you guys can better see what's in it. Your fuel tank, I think this is 600 cc's, I believe, 600 cc fuel tank. They include a clunk. Gaui recommends using a header tank, which I already have, but in the kit, I'm going to buy and end up with two header tanks, with the Gaui header tank too. But this plate here is for if you're running their mini V bar, it's a metal plate so that it has some weight behind it, some inertia. If you're using the B-Stex or like the MSH unit or the Icon, you won't need this metal plate because they're already, they have a metal case at the bottom. They're kind of weighty. Here's our 120T Mod 1 main gear. Pretty nice machining, looks really good. And then the bulk of the hardware here, linkages, aluminum, servo mounting hardware, bell housing, clutch, all those goodies are in here. Moving right along. Get rid of this big box. I think this is everybody's favorite box right here. And in this box, you're going to find your canopy and your frames. Get the box out of the way. I haven't opened this one yet, so total shocker here. Alright, got some skids, blade holder, carbon fiber mainframes. Nice thing about these frames is they are identical, so you could just buy a whole set of another frames, or just one frame, and if you break one side, you're good to go with just another frame. They're both the same part number. Can leave this out here, and we'll go ahead and open up this canopy. Looking at it in the light here, it looks beautiful. Very nicely done canopy. It's a pretty big canopy. It's a larger 500 from what I've seen here. It looks bigger than the Align or the Compass 500. It's a pretty big 500. I guess so because it's a nitro. So pretty sweet looking canopy. Here you go, guys. Just for some comparison, here's a T-Rex 500 canopy. Little Hammer's heli. As you can see, quite a difference in size there. There you go, hope you can see it. And an Atom 500 cano. It's not huge compared to them, but it's a lot bigger. Alright, so as promised, all the parts are out here. I opened up a bag here to get the head out. Give you guys some head real quick. Really nice head. I like how it's done. Seems pretty beefy. It's pre-assembled. The tail assembly comes together with your your spindle in it and your grips on it, bearings installed. Metal tail grip, really nice. All the quality in the machining has been really nice so far. Looking at all these parts, it's just, they did a great job with the machining. Here's your swash plate. Pretty generic, non-adjustable from what I can see, but you can remove your bearings. That's nice, you can actually change out your bearing. At least I think so. I'm not sure why these screws are in here. We'll find out. Like I said, the torque tube's assembled. Here it is. Whoops. I'm going to break the thing. Crash it. Let me zoom in a little bit. Try. It all came pre-assembled. It seems like it's flyable. I'm going to go ahead and take everything apart just so I can better learn the heli anyway. And reassemble it. Make sure all the Loctite's there. Most of the components out here are aluminum. Right here where the pitch slider, where you make the connection to the pitch slider here, that's metal. The tail box obviously is aluminum. This connection here is aluminum. Going down here, it just seems really beefy, nice. It's got a glossy finish. I like a matte black on the tail, but you know, whatever. Beautiful. In here you got your skid tubes, some battery straps, chromey looking, and I guess this is the tail boom support rods here. Chrome looking pretty nice. Not like a dusty aluminum or what you're common seeing black or, yeah, something a little different. They're pretty short. You know, it's a 500 size heli, so not very big. Like I said, the frames are the same part number. One frame. Now I got two frames. Same exact thing. They line up perfectly. They match up. All the holes are in the same spot. That's pretty nice. That's a nice feature. Like I said, it runs mini servos. You're going to have to get a throttle servo, three cyclics, a tail servo, and that's about it for servos. The takeoff here for the torque tube. Nice crown gears. This is actually, that's plastic. I thought it was metal for a sec. Really nice work on all these bits of aluminum. Very clean, nice machining. Everything looks like it'll work out really well for this heli. Some cross members and servo supports here. Like I said, the machining is really decent. I mean, being in helis for almost 6 years now, I've come across a couple nice machinists, and you know, sometimes it's bad, but most of the time, you know, you're getting some nice looking parts. And this is a standoff, I believe, for a servo. It's your servo mounting area. More here, the bearing blocks. Anti-rotation bracket. I think that's aluminum too. I believe it is. It's not flexing any. So an aluminum anti-rotation bracket, some mounting hardware, cross member supports, stiffeners and such. Very nicely machined. Not sure what the clip is for yet. We'll find out. Alright. Plastic. More aluminum. Bell housing, clutch bell housing, and a clutch. There's your clutch. All metal, nice chunky little bits. Main, pinion right there. 17T pinion. Thinking about switching up already before I even build it. Main gear, 120T main gear, Delrin. One-way bearing. Feels really nice. What else? 8mm main shaft. Sure, it's a shorter main shaft than what I'm used to seeing. I think that's because it's nitro. Tail boom support. I believe, not totally sure. Alright guys, so there you have it. That's what you can expect in your Gaui NX4 if you plan on getting one. I'm going to start working on mine as soon as I can. Like I said, I can't really afford to do it all at once, but over the next few weeks you'll start seeing it come together. I'll do some update videos. Be sure to check out the website for further information, the DaviHT3 at Weebly.com. And thanks for watching. Take care.